At about 10 months old, Miriam started displaying symptoms that seemed as though there could be some genetic abnormality. We did a chromosomal microarray. It yielded no results, but the geneticist did say there are facial features, bodily features, and behavioral features that are consistent with some kind of genetic mutation. We just can't identify anything at this time. It was frustrating to get the sense that probably there's something more complicated than what we can see at the surface level, and yet not have any answer.
When I first met Miriam and her mother, they came to me after a number of years of frustration. They've been to many different specialists, and they've been trying to figure out if there's an underlying diagnosis for Miriam, given all of the different symptoms that she's been having.
It was great sitting down with Dr. Byrne because she is an expert in what she does, and she instantly put us at ease. UConn ordered a whole exome sequencing. That is a very detailed test compared to the chromosomal microarray that we originally did. So that revealed many more details, specifically which gene is mutated and in what way, and then ruled out any other complications. So it was a very specific test that I didn't know existed before we met with UConn Genetics.
The UConn Health is one of two genetics programs in the whole state of Connecticut, and so the resources for genetics are quite scarce. And I spoke with her mom, and I let her know that fortunately, the genetic testing came back positive, and it was able to give us an underlying diagnosis for Miriam. She has a syndrome called Wiedemann-Steiner syndrome, which is incredibly rare.
I'd never heard of it before. And with fewer than 1,000 people worldwide diagnosed, why would I have heard?
The gene has only been discovered in 2012, and so prior to that, there was no diagnoses for patients with this disorder. Being able to put a name to something can really give a lot of relief to family who have gone through what I call like a medical odyssey or diagnostic odyssey when they come to genetics.
It was helpful also because it introduced us to an entire community of families whose kids have this syndrome.
The syndrome that Miriam was diagnosed with is very rare, but one of the important pieces is to make sure that the families recognize that they're not alone.
It's a real relief to have a diagnosis. It just confirms everything that we were seeing, that there is something unique and different about our daughter.